Welcome back. Research shows, easy to say, that most unhappy couples take 6 years before they seek therapy.
So how early is too early to ask for help? Well, we're joined now by relationship expert Melissa Ferrari. Melissa, good morning.
Hey, good morning.
It's normal for couples to go through ups and downs, of course, but what are the signs that you have reached a point where you need therapy as a couple?
If you're both starting to really live independent lives, you're losing interest in what your partner's actually doing. You're finding that there's disagreements and you both really aren't interested in fixing it. And a particular one is around if things are unequal. As humans, we like things to be fair and just. Mm. And if they're not, that and the scales tip too much in one way, that will create problems.
Mm. It's hard to initiate though, isn't it? To sort of say, like, maybe we should go to couples therapy. What do you think is the best way to say, I think we need help?
Well, I think sitting with your partner, first of all, face-to-face. Mm. Not over text, not over email, because you want to watch your partner's reaction. But discussing with them that you're noticing your own withdrawal, you're noticing your own disinterest in them, and bring them in a way of, this is beneficial for you. I'm not just doing this because I want to go to therapy and complain about you. I'm invested in us. I like our relationship and I want it to be better.
What about the trend of people starting couples counselling very early in the relationship, like pre-marriage? Can that be harmful in a way? Can that unnecessarily bring up things that aren't there, or is it always helpful? Always
helpful. It's a fabulous idea.
Okay.
I think it's a great place where you can start to form agreements. You need to know your partner and how to navigate them. Mm. Because for the rest of time, if you're deciding to make that kind of commitment, you need to know their vulnerabilities, who they are. And you're only really going to know that if you ask the right questions. And I think that a therapist helps you do that, because if there's something that we're all bringing stuff from childhood and previous relationships, it's important to know where the potholes are, because they're so easy to fall into in relationships.
You know, one of the things, my wife and I did couples therapy, like in the first year of being together. What I took from it, which was really interesting for me, was learning how to fight properly.
Mm.
And that takes away the fights. In a strange way, like, you start to communicate and then you realise, oh, now we just have conversations. And so it takes the heat out of everything.
It does. And the idea is there that, you know, the relationship is first. The integrity of this relationship is too important to me for us to argue about things where a lot of the time we're just wanting to be right.
Yeah.
You know, and it's like, do you want to be right or do you want to be married? You know, and that can be where people can get really stuck as well.
Yeah. Interesting. So what are some simple ways that we can all improve the strength of our relationship?
First of all, going face to face when you're having conversations. A little bit of gazing sometimes can be really helpful as well.
Mm.
Revisit your agreements, like, make agreements that are solid. Why are we in this relationship? We're in this relationship because we want longevity. We want to have that person. So look after it. You know, you're really going into a relationship to be with someone that'll do what others won't for you, really. And also, you know, learning to regulate each other's emotions. We're very much in sync as a couple. That whole bonding experience in the beginning is real. And so co-regulating each other emotionally is important.
Mm.
Meaning, I can see you're upset today, sweetheart, and attending to it is going to go really far in the longevity of a relationship.
Also, if you have a problem, you can say, well, let's wait and speak about it with our therapist and let's see if we can sort this out.
Exactly. Therapy is great for that. And being able to park it, having that person that can really see. We as therapists can see what's going on when a couple can't, because you're in it.
Mm-hmm.
And so if we find the right thorn to remove, we can really help.
Interesting. You always have the answers. Thank you, Melissa.
Thanks, Melissa.
See you soon.
Thank you.
Stay with us. When we return, we'll have the latest Nine News headlines.